Hey friends, this is Brandon from This Is Tech Today, and I have 10 hidden in advance tips for you for the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus. Tip number one is in regards to the settings menu. Normally, if you swipe down with one finger, you have to swipe down two times in order to access the settings. If you use two fingers, you can immediately access those settings, just like that. Tip number two is the ability to use the fingerprint scanner to swipe down that settings menu. So go to your settings, click on the gear, and type in finger sensor gestures. Click on that, and then turn it on. Now when you swipe down on the fingerprint sensor, the notification shade will come down. There you go. Tip number three is the screen and font size. Go into your settings and click on display, and then you'll see font and screen zoom. So you can change how much the phone zooms into an area, as well as the font size. So if you happen to have a grandparent or it's difficult to read small text, you can change that here. You can even change the font. And then another thing, the Galaxy S9 and Galaxy S9 Plus, for some reason, defaults to a 1080p resolution. So you can turn it up to WQHD Plus. You have such a nice display on the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus, why not use it to its full potential? This next one is my favorite, and I do this on every single device. If you scroll all the way down to About Phone, click on Software Information, and then on build number, tap it a few times, type in your PIN, and it says developer mode has been turned on. Go to the last page, go back again, and then scroll all the way down to the bottom and you'll see developer options. Scroll all the way down to drawing, or where you see the animation scale, and change it. But before we do that, let's look at how fast animations are. Okay, do you see how fast it is there? Now, if you click on each one and change it to 0.5x, see how fast it is now? It's super snappy. This is my favorite tip. And no, it doesn't impact your battery life. Tip number five is the ability to double tap on the menu switcher and go to the last app that you had open. So if you just double tap on it, it'll pull up the last app that you're in. Tip number six is the ability to pin a window. So if you go into your settings, go to lock screen and security, scroll all the way down to the bottom, click on other security settings, and then scroll down again, and then enable pin windows. And then to use this, just click on the menu button, and then scroll up. And you see that little pin there? If you click on that, now the window is pinned. If you click on the home button, it won't let you out of it. So this is really great if someone asks to borrow your phone and you don't want them to snoop around on your device. Or you have kids and you want them to only play the game. In order to exit this, just hold the back button and then the menu button, and then it's unpinned. Tip number seven is the list view feature in the app's overview. So if you click on the menu button and then the three dots at the top right, you can choose list view. It looks a little clean that way, right? And then if you want to go back to thumbnail view, just click in the three dots again and click thumbnail view. There you go. Tip number eight is the ability to lock a particular app so that whenever you close all of your apps, this one doesn't close with it. So hit the menu button and then the three dots at the top right, and then select lock apps, and then choose the app that you want to lock. Hit that and then done. And then now when you hit close all, settings will remain. Tip number nine is the ability to have a split screen. So you just hit the menu button, and then there's this little icon right here that has the two lines. You can click on that, and then it'll go to split screen. So now you can utilize both apps at the same time, and you can even resize it. And to get out of it, just swipe all the way down. There you go. Tip number 10 is the pop-up action view, which is a lot like the chat heads option for Facebook Messenger. So just hold down on the menu screen, and then click and hold on the app that you want to go into the pop-up view, and drag it there. And there it is, it's in a little mini window. And then there's a little bubble that you can move around on your screen. And then click on it, and it pops out. I know I said there was 10 tips, but here's a bonus one. I know a few of you probably noticed that my navigation buttons are a bit different. If you go to your settings, and in search, just type in navigation bar, and then click on it again, and then you'll see the button layout at the very bottom. So this is the default layout for Samsung devices. If you click on it again, it'll look like a stock Android or Pixel device. So there are my top 10, or really 11, hidden in advance tips and tricks for you on your brand new Samsung Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus. If you have any other tips and tricks that you'd like to share, go ahead and leave them down below in the comments. And while you're at it, go ahead and give me a thumbs up and subscribe. And if you want to have notifications on when I post a video, go ahead and hit that bell icon. If you'd like to get your hands on the wallpaper that I have a wallpaper mega thread from Twitter that's located in my description. And then check out some more of my videos that I have on the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus, including a white stone dome glass screen protector and cases. Thanks Thanks again for watching This Is Tech Today. Until next time.